Excuse me as I kiss the sky. So I wanted to come on here for a brief moment and talk about this situation between Centoya Brown and her new husband's son's mother. Her name is Stacy Kirkland. Now, if you don't know who Centoya Brown is, Centoya Brown was just recently granted clemency because she was arrested when she was 16 for the murder of her abuser. She was caught in like a sex trafficking ring. Let me read the article for you. It says, Centoya Brown must stay away from her 11-year-old stepson after a judge recently granted a restraining order filed by the boy's mother. Stacy Kirkland shares a son with Jamie Long, the former Pretty Ricky member and Christian rapper whom Brown married while she was in prison. According to documents obtained by Bossip, Kirkland is extremely concerned about the safety of her son and does not believe that he will take proper measures to protect the child from danger. Kirkland lives in Texas with their son, while Long moved to Tennessee where he lives with Brown. The judge approved Kirkland's request after Long failed to respond. Long is not allowed to take the boy outside of the state or discuss the case in front of him. In the documents, Kirkland reportedly stated that while she would love for Long to spend more time with their son, in light of Jamie Long's recent decision to enter into a romantic committed relationship with a woman convicted of first-degree murder, she is extremely fearful. She adds that Long did not inform her that he was getting married, which is part of their custody agreement. Allegedly, the documents are also stated that in 2018, Long only spent one day in the entire year around his son. Centoya Brown is a former teenage child sex trafficking victim who served 15 years in prison for murder and was released in August. In addition to getting married to Jamie Long, Brown earned two college degrees while behind bars. So the question here is, would you allow your children to be around their new stepmom who was once convicted of murder? And the mom said in court papers that Centoya Brown's status as a convicted murderer has put her on edge, and she believes that Jamie Long is so blinded by love that he won't take the steps to keep their son safe. Under Long and Kirkland's original parenting plan, one parent was supposed to let the other one know if they intended to marry or live with someone else. But Kirkland said in court papers that she heard from third parties that Long was in a relationship with Brown, which prompted the worried mom to file a motion to change their son's custody terms and seek a restraining order that would stop Brown from coming within 500 feet of her son. She said that Long moved to Tennessee in February 2019 to be closer to Brown, who was released from state prison in August 2019. Also inside of the affidavit, the mom said, I would love for Jamie to spend more time with our son. However, in light Jamie's recent decision to enter into a romantic committed relationship with a woman convicted of first degree murder, I am extremely fearful. Jamie didn't respond to the lawsuit, so the judge put him in default. And now Jamie will only have supervised visits with his own son. And he isn't allowed to have his son around Centoya. Now, here's my thing. Instantly, everybody just assumed that Jamie Long's son's mother was just this bitter, jealous woman who is angry because Jamie has moved on to someone else. This isn't the first person that they have pinned to be malicious and cruel. They also said this about Pam Long, who is Jamie Long's ex-wife. She is a former member of Total. And when everybody found out that Jamie and Centoya were married, Pam started being vocal and warning Centoya about how manipulative Jamie was. I saw in my comment section on my Facebook page, immediately people were just pinning this man's son's mother as if she was just vindictive. And my thing was, so this man only spent one day in 2018 with his son. all year. He hasn't even seen his son. The fact that he didn't even respond to the court says how much he cares about his son. So I believe that the mother is trying to, number one, get more child support. If Long ignores the court order, he faces a $500 fine for each violation and 6 months in jail, the court papers say. The judge also increased the child support payments that Jamie Long has to pay, which are now $527 a month, and that includes $300 for the son's health insurance. Now, that child support payment must have been low as hell. And Jamie swears up and down like he's this financially stable person who has millions and takes care of Santoya. But if he actually had that type of income, that child support would be much higher than $527, because they factor in how much income both of those parents make. So if Jamie Long actually made the amount of money he claims he made when he was on The Breakfast Club just recently talking about how, you know, financially stable he is because of the businesses that he has, the child support payments will be much higher. $527 a month is the total, and this includes the $300 for the son's health insurance. So his original child support had to be low. It had to be like only $200, if that much.
So now there's a restraining order on his wife because he didn't even bother showing up to court or even responding. Now, if he's this millionaire like he claims he is, I'm pretty sure he has attorneys. He could have had his attorney at least respond to the situation. A lot of people are also talking about the whole concept of him having to say that he's going to be married or in a relationship or he's living with someone. A lot of people are like, why is that inside of the court order? Well, that was their parenting plan. When you go to the courts, right, when you go through the courts, they organize your situation. And one of the things that they do is require that you have a parenting plan. And they agreed to have a parenting plan, which was, okay, if either one of us decides to get inside of a relationship or allow someone to move in or remarry, we must discuss it beforehand. And that makes sense because when you have children together, and you bring another person into the family who isn't blood or who hasn't been there from the beginning, you kind of got to have a conversation to try to figure out where everybody's head is and try to get everybody on one accord as far as raising the child. So it makes a lot of sense to have that inside of the agreement that they, you know, just have to tell each other. Oh, I saw that that was one of the first things that someone felt uncomfortable with inside of my comment section. They was just like, why does he have to say he's inside of a relationship? And I can always tell when I'm dealing with someone who doesn't have children, because people who have children know, okay, if I get in a relationship with someone, that person is going to be around my kids. If me and the person that I have a child with are already having a communication problem or our situation is toxic already, and then you want to bring a third party in or a fourth party in, it might cause even more of a problem. So the breaks in communication with two people who are co-parenting causes a lot of problems. Personally, with me, as long as you love my child, as long as you, you know, take care of my child and are as responsible as I would be with my child, then I will trust you with my child. Listen, if y'all have been watching Investigation Discovery and Snapped and the Oxygen Channel and all of these true crime stories about how kids were killed by the new person in the relationship, or one of the parents was upset about the breakup, so they decided to kill their own kid. You see stuff like that all of the time when you're watching true crime. And this is real stuff that's happening to real people. This isn't make-believe stuff. This is real stuff that's really happening. So you got to be very protective of your children. So I see why this mother is doing this, but at the same time, I also understand how people could think she's just jealous of Jamie being married to Santoya.
I think I would have did the same thing in regards to my son. Because number one, if my son's father married someone, he married this person who was a murderer, and now they are released from jail, even after they've done a decade in prison, I would still factor in all of the things that that person had to go through within those 10 years of being in prison. Just because you tried to change your life around doesn't mean you still didn't have to fight for your life and survive in prison. Because prison ain't no pretty place. So I think if I felt uncomfortable with my son's father's new wife, I probably would have did the same, especially if she
is a murderer or was a murderer. I don't know what it say is or was, but either way, murderer needs to not be something that describes my son's father's new wife. I'm sorry. I can't. Okay. I can put up with a lot of things, but I don't know about that. Now, maybe if I had some interaction with this woman myself, maybe, but I doubt it even then. One guy came into my comment section and said, you know, she's an innocent person. I'm like, whoa. No one who's committed murder is an innocent person. Like, I'm surprised that you would even say something like that. Just because she was 16 doesn't mean she was innocent. At 16, you still know that killing someone is wrong. And how she ended up in a sex trafficking ring to begin with, I don't know. I don't know the history of Centoya, but I do know she did her time and she was granted clemency. Yeah, I have compassion for her and her situation, but have her around my kids? I don't know. I don't think so. You can't just have any woman be around your children. Now, granted, she said he only saw, Jamie has only seen his son one time in 2018. So he doesn't really spend a lot of time with his son to begin with. Knowing the details of the situation to the degree I know it, the only conclusion I could come up with is that this woman is very protective of her son, and something must have happened that made her feel uncomfortable enough to file this motion. And he basically didn't follow the court order to begin with, because he was supposed to tell his son's mother if he got in a new marriage or if he got in a new relationship with somebody else, and he didn't tell her that. So she had to find out from somewhere else that he was in a relationship with Centoya when she was in prison. So that's him violating his court order to begin with. So fellas, you know, you got to be sensitive about this when you're dealing with the new women in your life. And of course, as women, we are supposed to trust the fathers of our children to make a good decision when they're choosing stepmoms for our children. You still have to factor in that she was in prison for 15 years, and you can only imagine what she was doing inside of that prison outside of going out there marrying Jamie Long and getting 2 bachelor's degrees. You still have to fight for your life. You're in prison. And she learned how to be an adult in prison. And the way that prison is set up is very different than how it's set up in the real world. So I see people's concerns. I understand what people are saying. But at the end of the day, I just hate that they classify this mother as just some bitter person. I personally think she's using this opportunity to get Jamie to be around his son more and also to get more child support. We should be able to trust their judgment if that person is a good father. But being as though Jamie only saw his son one time in an entire year, that says a lot about his father-son relationship. So he might not be the best father in the world to begin with. I also noticed that people overlook the fact that this man is a deadbeat, that he hasn't been taking care of his child, and they went straight for the mother of his child and just call the mother of his child vindictive and petty. But they seem to overlook the fact that this man has abandoned his son. He only spent one day in the entire year of 2018 with his son. Y'all have to factor this in, and we're talking about someone who's quote unquote a star. Like, people look at Jamie Long as if he's a celebrity or he's a star. So of course he has the financial backing to go out there and visit his son. He has plane ride money. You know, he has the resources associated with being able to see his son, but he hasn't. And he also hasn't been really taking care of him financially. And people just overlook this altogether and just automatically thought, oh, the baby mama's doing this because she's vindictive. No, not everybody is sitting around here having an issue with their former partner being with someone new. See, people are extremely judgmental. I noticed that. If you hate your ex that you share a child with, people judge you. If you're cool with your ex and have like this decent friendship where y'all go on vacations together, like Alicia Keys and Will Smith and his baby mamas do, y'all think that's creepy and weird. Y'all gotta make up your mind. Is it okay for a person to be jealous and vindictive and not like their ex? Or is it okay for them to be friends and be cool and go out here and vacation with each other? Which one is it? To me, I just want a healthy environment. Like I've said before, me and my daughter's father have an amazing relationship. We are great friends. He's flying to go on vacation with me, him, and his daughter, and my daughter's boyfriend. So, I mean, like, we cool. He could have, listen, my daughter's father could have brought his girlfriend with him, and I would have been completely fine with that. I would have let her stay in my house and everything. I trust my daughter's father's judgment as far as when he wants to pick a woman. But see, my daughter is 18, so she can fend for herself. If my daughter was younger, like maybe my son's age, my son is one, okay? If my daughter was younger and my daughter's father wanted to possibly, you know, come to my house for a vacation and, you know, I would have this woman around a young child, I would want to know who she is, what she's doing, what type of person she is. I would not allow her into my home if she was a murderer. I don't care. If she went to prison for 15 years, murdered someone, I wouldn't want her in my house. I don't know her. Now, if I got to know her and then time went by and I could possibly trust her, I probably would. I'm telling you, that red flag, or if I feel any type of discomfort, I would completely dismiss her altogether. I wouldn't want my kids around her. So I feel what this woman is saying. I feel anyone who has kids will look at this and be a little like, eh. Now, I didn't know Jamie had kids, because all I knew about was that he was married to Pam from Total. I didn't know he had kids by someone else, but him and Pam were married for a year. So I didn't know that he had a child until I heard of this story. His child is 11, yo. I don't know. Tell me what you think in the comment section below, okay? Have vision and stay focused. Namaste.